Welcome back to my channel. My name is Gabby if you're new here, and today's video, as you can tell by the title, we are going to be comparing the on-the-fly pants to the new keep moving pants from Lululemon. Now I know this is kind of old news, but I just got my hands on a size 0 in the keep moving pant, and obviously they don't have these in store, so I have not actually tried on my true size in these pants. So I wanted to do a first impressions and review for you guys to let you know my thoughts on the pant. So if you want to know which pant is better in my opinion, then just keep watching. So first of all, I'm going to go over kind of each pant and then the differences between the two pants just on physical appearance, and then I'm going to try them on for you guys and review them that way and then give you my final thoughts. Let's start with the on-the-fly pant. The on-the-fly line has been around at Lululemon for quite some time, and I think before that they were called something else, and the keep moving pant or stretch high-rise pant line came in to replace the on-the-fly line. And I know that there are some very split opinions about this new line. So I actually have two pairs of the on-the-fly pants. This one is in gray sage. These are the 7/8 length, and these ones are in black, but these are the full length pants, and both of these are in a size 0. So I do like to size down in the jogger type pants just because I like a more of a slim fitted look instead of a baggier look. However, I think these pants are great for many different occasions. I've seen people train in these, I've seen people wear these for nursing, wear these to work, wear these to school, etc. They are so versatile. They are made for on the move, which is more intended for that lifestyle athleisure look. So I've had mine for 2-3 years now, and I absolutely love them. I definitely wish I bought more when these were still in stock. As you can see, there is a drawstring right here that ties. They have two metal, I don't know, ends, I guess you could say, with them, with the Lululemon logo. And then the pockets have a little mesh, a mini mesh pocket in here to hold like your key or something, and then the other pocket is obviously just a plain pocket. It has kind of the ruching band on it, and this is kind of this stretch, so it does kind of, I don't know, not want to stretch as much. Like, you can feel the resistance, but I would say that they're still pretty stretchy. And this is what the pant is on the bottom. I think it's mostly the same. They have the little Lulu logo right there, and same with these pants. They're just a little bit longer, of course, so they are the full length ones. Both of these are the luxury material, and I know that the on the flies also came in a woven material, which was more kind of a linen-y, cottony feel. Those ones didn't seem to be as popular in my opinion. I know that there was a lot of reviews saying that they weren't as stretchy, but these ones do have the four-way stretch, so as you can see that they would stretch this way and this way. That's really what the four-way stretch means, is that they can stretch in both directions. There, you can see that give. So that's the on-the-fly pant. These are also mid-rise. Honestly love them though. And then these are the new keep moving pant, or the stretch high-rise 7/8 pant. I think they're renaming them to this because they were called the keep moving pant on the website, but as you can see, this tag does say stretch high-rise pant, and I know that's what the joggers called, and now they just came out with shorts to obviously go with the line. This is what they look like. You can see that it has a lot more ruching on the top, and the band is more stretchy, but it does still have a little bit of resistance to it. And as you can tell, that the drawstrings are different. These ones are more of a like athletic-y feel drawstrings, whereas these ones were more of a, like a dressy, I guess, drawstring. I don't know if that makes any sense, but as you can see, the drawstrings are completely different. And these ones don't have the shiny ends to them. They just have matte ones, but they do have the logo. Another difference that I did notice, obviously these pockets are mesh as well, but instead of the mesh small pocket, instead these ones have a zippered pocket. And I think it is actually quite spacious. So you can fit like, you know, a good decent sized card in here, where the other one is more just for like a very small item. So I do kind of like that. And then these ones are 7/8, but they kind of look more full length, like in comparison when I like stretch them out for my arm length. They definitely look a lot longer, so that's interesting. Also, they moved the logo to the top of the pant instead of on the bottom of the pants. So I guess that's okay if, you know, you're wearing them to work and you don't really need a logo on the side of your leg. This one's a little bit more hidden. These drawstrings are also supposed to tuck back inside so that you have a hidden drawstring. Now, bear with me as I attempt to figure this out. Okay, so you're supposed to thread them through the hole that they are coming out of, and then they should just come through the other side like that, and boom, you don't have a drawstring. So I think that's definitely a unique feature. If you are wearing them to work, then it does look a little bit more dressy without the drawstring. They look a little bit more as a, you know, work pant. So I kind of like that you can reverse them, but for a more casual look, you can pull them back out and of course have the tie at the front. I'm not sure, we're gonna see how comfortable it is to have the strings inside as well, because I know like the Fast and Freeze, Speed Up, Swift Speeds, Invigorate, Wonder Trains all come with the drawstring also on the inside, and I know tying them up sometimes can be a little bit uncomfortable as well for people just when they're working out. So I really want to test that. But yeah, that's what these pants look like, and I'm very skeptical because the only ones that I've tried on are two, and they were just way too big for me, way too baggy. I didn't really like the fit, and these ones are high rise, so I am interested to see how those compare to the mid rise ones. However, I have heard apparently some educators are saying a lot of people are looking for mid rise pants still. So there is that, and I also know that a lot of people want the on the fly line to come back, including myself. I really enjoy it, but let's go try this on and see if my mind will be changed. Okay, so these are the on the fly pants. These ones are the 7/8 length, so you can see that they hit right at my ankle, which I think is a great length for dressy pants, etc. But sometimes my ankles do get cold, so that's why I purchased the full length version. But honestly, I think these are so comfortable. I love the Luxtreme fabric. It's very smooth and soft. They are mid-rise, so they hit just below my belly button. But yeah, honestly, a staple. These are one of my favorite pants. I love to dress them up or even wear them casually as well. So I am very impressed with these pants. Okay, so these are the on-the-fly full length ones. As you can see, they go right down to my foot. They hit, these ones hit actually just at the belly button for me, so I think that's just maybe something to do with the inseam length. But overall, I really enjoy these pants. They're super soft, comfortable, stretchy. They are definitely slimmer through the leg, as you can see, but these are the on-the-fly full-length pant. Okay, so this is my first time trying these pants even on in a zero. And I also just read on the tag that the waistband here is made of Nulu, so that's super interesting, and I do think it is super comfortable. Not that the other ones weren't comfortable, I think they are very comfortable, but these ones do feel kind of like you're wearing the Align legging on the top with the Luxtreme on the bottom, so I think that's kind of cool and very comfy. These ones obviously are high rise, so my belly button's here, so they hit just above it, and I kind of like the high rise as well. I'm just, you know, a high rise girl. These ones are definitely much longer, as you can see. They hit maybe half an inch to an inch longer than the 7/8 length. However, they're not as long as the full length on the fly. So they're a little bit in the middle, which I think is interesting. I'm not sure if it's good or bad yet. And then I just have the drawstrings on the inside right now, just as a more work pant vibe. I do feel like the pockets are slightly different. They feel different here. Something feels different. I definitely think the zeros fit me much better, but they are much baggier here, just in the back of the pant in general, and in the side. You can see that it kind of gaps a little bit more away from the leg than it does with the on-the-fly pants, which I'm not a huge fan of. I don't really like that there's so much crease going on here. It definitely kind of reminds me of grandma pants. No hate to grandmas. I don't know how to feel above these. In some ways, I think there's definitely an advantage. I like the drawstring adjustability, the waistband in Nulu, and the larger zippered pocket, although the zipper is kind of hard to grab hold of and for ease of access kind of thing. Oh, there is a little mesh pocket actually in here. So there's two pockets, which is very interesting. A pocket within a pocket within a pocket. I don't know. I don't think I really like how big it is in the knee. I think that's the biggest thing that I'm not a huge fan of these pants so far. But I do have to say that the zeros fit much better. Okay, that just took me like 2 minutes to try and get this drawstring back outside of the pant. So I'd have to say that even though that's cool that you can like flip them around and stuff, it's not very easy to do so in a hurry. Be mindful of that. Maybe it gets better with practice. I don't really know. I definitely think I like them better with the drawstring tucked in. As you can see, this one sticks out really funny, like literally out, whereas the keep moving pants kind of hang a little bit more, which I kind of like. I think this looks a little funny to me. It's not bad. It definitely gives it more of a casual jogger look. So overall, I don't hate these pants as much as I thought, but I don't know if they're a lot. So the stretch high-rise 7/8 pants do retail for $128, where the on-the-flies were $108. So these ones are $20 more expensive. I think if I had to choose just one of these pants to keep, I would still keep my on-the-fly pants. I thoroughly enjoy them. Like I said, they are one of my favorite pants I've ever purchased from Lululemon. However, I do see the pros to this pant. I think if you wanted to wear a crop top, be a line tank or a cropped tee, like a Kate's tee, something like that, these would be better because obviously your belly button is covered. So in those instances, I would reach for these ones. However, I think I would still gravitate more towards the on-the-fly pants just because of the way they fit. I enjoy the on-the-fly pants, but I think these are a good alternative if you get the right size. I wish they were a little bit tighter in the knee. I do know they're supposed to be a little bit more of that relaxed fit type thing, which isn't bad, but I think for more dressy occasions, it doesn't look as good. It doesn't look as professional as if they were actually like fitted, if that makes sense. Not like tight, but like they're fitted. I don't know if it's still worth the conversion. I liked that you can take the drawstring and put it inside. I think it definitely makes the pant more versatile, more dressy for those occasions. I did not like the drawstring as much on the outside of the pant. I would have the drawstrings on the inside all the time just because they sat very flat and weirdly awkward on me, and the bow part was very large, whereas with the on-the-fly pant, the tie kind of just sits and hangs there, whereas this is like... I did really enjoy the Nulu waistband. I think that it added like a little bit of like extra comfort to it, but honestly with the on-the-fly pant, I don't really notice the waistband that much. So I think that's not like a huge selling factor. The one thing about these is they are much longer, not much longer, but they are longer than the on-the-fly 7/8 pant. And the only thing I didn't really like is that they are much roomier in the seat and back of the knee area. So I think if you know you had more muscular thighs, then this would be a great pant. I do enjoy the high rise of it as well, just some extra coverage, but honestly it was only about maybe half an inch extra material just to cover my belly button, whereas the other ones just hit at my belly button. But I definitely want to know your thoughts. Have you tried them? Have you converted over? Let me know, because I don't know, maybe I just need to give these ones a little bit more of a try, more of a test run to really see the full potential of these pants. But I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, please remember to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you're new here, and turn on post notifications so you're notified when I post new Lululemon videos and vlogs. And with that, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.